Rising number of adolescent mothers in the Philippines prompts groups to call for the passage of a bill that seeks to establish interventions to prevent teenage pregnancies. More from Ara Perez.
Over 300 civil society organizations and government agencies come together to urge lawmakers anew to pass the Adolescent Pregnancy Prevention Bill, which institutionalizes programs to avoid teenage pregnancy and implements interventions as needed. For these groups, teenage pregnancy must not be the norm.
The Commission on Population and Development, together with other stakeholders here present, call for our esteemed senators to please pass the Adolescent Pregnancy Prevention Bill. And then also, we acknowledge and we call on our institutions, particularly our local government units, to also pass ordinances and policies on Executive Order Number 141, where adolescent pregnancy is an urgent national priority.
Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel, one of the bill's authors, says this has been passed on third and final reading in the House of Representatives while still pending on second reading in the Senate. For Manuel, aside from teenage mothers, all youths will benefit from the measure as this will empower them.
We also believe na habang, of course, maraming mga nangyayari ngayon sa ating bayan, day-to-day may mga sumusulpot na mga developments no, sa loob man o sa labas ng pamahalaan, pero it doesn't mean na isa-shelve ang ating bill. Hopefully po, bago matapos ang 19th Congress, in just a few months ay mapirmahan na ito.
In public schools, the Philippine Education Department sees a significant decrease in the number of teenage pregnancies, especially when students gradually return to in-person classes. An official of the agency sees the integration of comprehensive sexuality education in the curriculum as one of the contributing factors.
Based on our latest data, if I remember correctly, from 2021 to 2022, that was about 30,000 teenage pregnancy cases. The year preceding that, mas mataas, about 37,000. But when we were able to revert back to face-to-face classes and mas naging robust yung ating implementation ng comprehensive sexuality education, bumukas yung mga teen centers natin, we were able to provide additional programs for adolescent reproductive health, we saw a significant decrease to about 13,000 na lang na teenage pregnancy cases.
Teachers are trained to talk about sexuality issues, from basic topics like body parts, value of consent, consisting of good touch or bad touch, to sensitive topics like what to do and where to report when harassment arises, family planning, among others. Galban says their ultimate goal is to eliminate teenage pregnancy with the help of community-driven programs, but admits they need the help of parents and families to reach the objective.
It is very dangerous on their health kasi of course their bodies are still developing. Kumbaga, bata pa sila tapos magkapalaki na sila ng bata. That is a very concerning issue. But at the same time, yung economic aspect, because the likelihood of not finishing is higher when you are taking care of someone already. Kailangan talaga ng tutok, hindi lamang ng eskwelahan, pero kasama rin ng mga magulang. Kaya katuwang din namin ng DSWD at DOH. It really takes a community.
Based on data from the Philippine Statistics Authority, adolescent pregnancies increased to 10% from over 136,000 recorded in 2021 to over 150,000 in 2022 for those aged 10 to 19 years old. Pregnancies among girls aged 10 to 14 years old also rose to 48% from more than 2,000 in 2020 to more than 3,000 in 2022. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
A miracle at sea, a Filipino fisherman who had gone missing for over a month survives his ordeal. 50-year-old Robin De Hilio was rescued by a passing cargo vessel while he was still in his small boat in the waters off Batanes. De Hilio had been floating at sea for, get this, 46 days and was suffering from extreme dehydration. He survived by drinking rainwater and eating fish that he caught. De Hilio was part of a bigger fishing crew when he lost his way back to the mothership last August 12. The Pasig Regional Trial Court issuing an arrest warrant for dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go over qualified trafficking charges. Adrian Aileen now joins us with more details. Adrian, go ahead.
Yes, and the Pasig City Regional Trial Court Branch 167 has issued a commitment order against former Bamban Mayor Alice Guo for her non-bailable qualified trafficking case in connection with the operation of illegal Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs. In the decision of presiding Judge Aniline Medes Capelis, the court ordered the transfer of Guo from the Philippine National Police Custodial Facility in Camp Crame to the Pasig City Jail Female Dormitory. The court likewise ordered the transfer of Guo's co-accused, Walter Wong Long, from the Tarlac Provincial Jail to the Pasig City Jail Male Dormitory. In her decision, Judge Medes Cabelli said all the accused in the cases are not entitled to post bail as the charges against them are all non-bailable. Meantime, for the other accused who were still at large, the court issued an arrest warrant against them, namely Wang Jiyang, Rachel Joan Carion, Zhang Ruijin, Bao Yinglin, Yu Zhengkan, Dennis Cunanan, Jamie Lynn Cruz, Roderick Puhante, Juan Miguel Alpaz, Merly Joy Castro, Rita Iturralde, Rowena Evangelista, Thelma Laranan, and Maybelline Milo, also known as Shana Yee. The court noted that for all the accused, it found probable cause to hold trial for the crimes charged against them. The court scheduled the arraignment and pre-trial conference for Guo and Long on September 27 at 8:30 in the morning. Notice, Stanley, that what the court issued as far as Alice Guo and Walter Wong Long are concerned are commitment orders because they are already they have already been arrested and they are in fact already under the custody of the Philippine National Police. But as to the other accused who are still at large, the court ordered or issued an arrest warrant against them. Sandy?
Thank you very much for clarifying that it was, in fact, a commitment order and not an arrest warrant issued against Alice Guo. And so far, have you spoken to the lawyers of the former mayor for a reaction, Adrian?
Not yet. Stanley, we are still covering another. Anyway, we have yet to get the side of the lawyer, but of course, it is important to note that this is non-bailable, so yeah. They don't have any recourse, no other recourse. They cannot post bail because it is evident, it is clear in the order of Judge Medes Capelis that the cases are not bailable. So what will happen here, we are looking forward to the arraignment and pre-trial conference, which have already been scheduled. As far as Guo and Long are concerned, on September 27 at 8:30 in the morning. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for those updates, Adrian Aileen.